Human trafficking is a very serious issue in a country. And we can see the symptoms of human trafficking in almost every way of a life. One of the most common ones is when we go for a drive and we halt at the traffic signal. So at the traffic signal, it is quite likely that you would see a child who is begging or who is forced to sell something to you. It is quite likely that this child belonged to a very poor family, maybe in a state like Jharkhand. I give the example of Jharkhand because it is reported to have the highest incidence of human trafficking. So it is quite likely that this child has been separated from his family, parents, forcefully, maybe kidnapped, and transferred to a different city, maybe the metropolitans or any of the smaller cities. So they are engaged in this. It is quite likely that it is not just traffic signal, it is prostitution racket. A girl child is forced into it. Or it is possible that a child is forced into work as a bonded labor. So anything is possible. So we can see the human trafficking. There are a lot of symptoms, but somehow we do not pin the same to human trafficking. And it is likely because we do not show the level of consciousness or awareness that is required on this issue. Talking about awareness, every year, 30th of July is marked as a World Day on Human Trafficking. And then, to correct the issue of human trafficking, the recent government has brought out a bill on trafficking in persons, prevention, care and rehabilitation. So it is introduced this very year, 2021. It's an updated bill actually. So this law has been brought out, and therefore this topic is very important for UPSC Civil Services examination. Now coming forward to the analysis, let us see the definition of human trafficking. It is defined as the trade of humans, most commonly for the purpose of sexual slavery, forced labor, or commercial sexual exploitation for the trafficker or others. This is the acquisition of people by improper means such as force, fraud, or deception. So improper means, acquisition, these are important terms in the definition, and it tells us a story over here. And why is this done? Because their people, traffickers, exploiters, want to earn money. So it is estimated that this is a trade worth $150 billion. And if we talk about the victims, there are 21 million victims, majority of them being women or girls. And most of them engaged in sexual exploitation, then as forced labor. And then could be any other offense, maybe it could be handling of the drugs, illegal diamond trade, or it could be organ trafficking. So any activity is just the trade of human beings, human trafficking, and then in any activity over here. Now one key fact from the NCRB, that is one way of identifying human trafficking, is the number of people that go missing in the FIR, they are filed as such. So as per official estimates, 15 children go missing every hour and 8 are never found. That is, more than half of them are never found. And this affects the rights of the child, the rights of the family, and so on. So this is a very serious problem over here. Now let us see what things have we learned over here, or the important identifications. So one is that it is the children and women that are most vulnerable. That is why we see most of the government schemes are centered over these issues. And then it is a conduit to several other crimes. So it is not just human trafficking, it is also forced labor, sexual slavery, right? Illegal organ trade, anything, organized crime, whatever. So it can all be linked to human trafficking. And then there is a socio-economic dimension to it. Social, the right of the child, the right of the family to live together and the opportunities, the problem of poverty, the economic trade is an example of the economic dimension over here. So both are related over here, social evils as well as the economic aspect. Now let us see the measures taken by the government to address the issue of human trafficking. Now we know that our constitution has provision of Article 23. So 23 prohibits traffic in human beings or forced labor. Now this is a child, this is violative of Article 23(1) over here. And also it is violative of Article 21(4). Article 24 talks about abolition of child labor. So both are related. So we can just draw an extension over here. And moving forward, the government has passed a law long back, that is Immoral Traffic Prevention Act 1956. This is the primary law that deals with the issue of human trafficking in India. Next, criminal law or the Indian Penal Code was amended. It keeps getting amended. But in the year 2013, amendments were also made keeping in mind the issue of human trafficking. So they wanted to make, the parliament wanted to make the laws in compliance with the protocol on human trafficking, that is of the United Nations. So that was done. That is, this is known as Section 370 of the IPC. So this is a very important change. And then if we can go further, like I told you about Article 24, there are several other legislations, that is legislation on organ trade or legislation on prevention of children from sexual offenses, right? So there are so many other things that can be linked to human trafficking. So it will be a big, become very big analysis. Now some schemes that the government has introduced for human trafficking. So these are two important ones, that is Ujjavala and Sudhar Grah. Grah means house. So Ujjavala, you know, here you have to be very careful. There is one scheme of the government which is PM Ujjwala Yojana. It's about LPG, right? In that, this A is missing. That you have to keep in mind. This one, this particular scheme is about, it is about the prevention of trafficking, rescue, rehabilitation, reintegration and repatriation of victims, primarily women victims of human trafficking. So this is the Ujjwala scheme over here. And next is Sudhar Grah, for women who are from extreme poverty, right, who are victims of human traffic, but are victims of extreme poverty or in very difficult circumstances, for them Sudhar Grah has been introduced. So these are two very important schemes of women, Ministry of Women and Child. Now this is very important. Please take a note of this, that the funding has come down because we'll subsequently use it in this answer. Now next is, in the year 2010, to address the issue of rescue, rehabilitation, whatever, anti-human trafficking units were established. So 2010. Which are specialized district task force comprising of police and government officials. So their job was to track and identify it. So 300 of these were to be established. So the primary role of this would be law enforcement, and it would liaise with other concerned agencies for care and rehabilitation of victims. Now still, I mean, so much has been done. So there is no shortage of a law or a policy actually. So much has been done, but still we find this. We see a high incidence of human trafficking in a country. So therefore some corrective measures are needed. So let us see what can be done. First thing is, we need a better implementation. We need to plug gaps in implementation, right? And when we talk about implementation, we need to identify that there is an unholy nexus. This $150 billion trade, it's quite likely that powerful people are engaged in it, which stops the implementation. So we need better implementation. We need more funding in Ujjwala and Sudhar Grhe. Also in this regard, we need to focus on the anti-human trafficking units. So these units were established for rescue operations and then ultimately sent them for rehabilitation. But you know what? 300 units were to be created. Of this, 255 are done. That's fine. But not adequate money is given. Not adequate manpower is provided or skills that are required. So therefore, this is large, by and large, a very defunct organization. Maybe in certain places it is doing a good job, but by and large, it is very poor in its application. So we need to strengthen the existing AHTUs. And we need to have an holistic approach over here. Holistic. See, whatever we have done, we are talking about rescue, we are talking about rehabilitation, right? That is one way. We have to look at the socio-economic aspect also, the social side, the economic side, the issue of poverty and how the people are getting diverted, the issue of creating awareness. And also, if you see the legislations, there is one about the traffic, but then where several legislations are there which are independently looking at domains which are clubbed together for human trafficking. So we need to have an independent law also in this reference. And to fulfill all of this, we need good political will. So without political will, we are not going to have implementation. We are not going to strengthen the AHTU and forget about holistic approach. So political will is a must over here. So no matter you keep bringing in new and new bills, you strengthen the provisions, you bring in the National Investigative Agency, but without political will, it is not going to function. So this is all we have in this analysis on human trafficking in India. I have not discussed the bill. We'll have the bill separately. So this is all. Thank you for streaming in to IS Primers with me, Shubhashish Singh Rehal. Bye-bye, take care and all the best. And please do like, share and subscribe. Don't forget.